there's a problem plaguing these beautiful turquoise waters of St. Croix. It's time to gear up and spare the issue head first. Today we're going to go hunting just south of the famous Frederiksted Pier. My name is Salty Locs and I hunt lionfish, and if you're down, I'd like to take you with me.
Let's go.
1 second while I braid my hair. This is going to be a shore dive, so work those legs and let's paddle out from shore to the reef. Let's take a look below. And if you wouldn't mind, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And like the video if you're feeling the vibe. Large or small, we remove them all. The lionfish is a super predator. They have taken up residence very far from home. Originally found in the Indo-Pacific, they are invasive to the Caribbean Sea. The lionfish population is continuing to grow and increase its range. Here are a few reasons that's a problem. This is largely because lionfish have no known predators and reproduce all year long. A mature female releases approximately 2 million eggs a year. The native would-be predators don't recognize them as food, and the native fish don't recognize them as a predator. This invasive species has the potential to harm reef ecosystems because it is a top predator that competes for food and space with overfished native stock such as snapper and grouper. Scientists fear that lionfish left unchecked have the potential to kill off helpful species such as algae-eating parrotfish, allowing seaweed to overtake the reefs. My prongs are too spaced out to catch the little lionfish, so I need to adjust. It takes a bit more precision to catch the smaller ones. They are capable of hiding out in any crease or crevice of the reef, so you have to keep an eye out. Looks like nothing but nuggets today. While we're swimming along the reef and near this patch reef, we are looking for common lionfish habitat. Any structure that would allow a lionfish to hide, such as under a rock, thick foliage, and sometimes even inside the barrel sponges. A shell pile up like this is a good indicator to me that an octopus could be nearby. I don't see one, but I'm sure there's one near. We can see several different juvenile reef fish now, but left unchecked, the lionfish could easily wipe them out. It has been found that within a short period of time after the entry of lionfish into an area, the survival of other reef fish is cut by about 80%. Large lionfish have been observed consuming 20 small fish in a 30-minute period. Check out this massive stingray buried in the sand. When not feeding, some stingrays bury themselves in the sand with only their eyes and spiracles visible, which is their breeding openings. Stingrays are not usually aggressive, super cool, but watch out for that barb. Thank you. My preferred pole spear is the Lionator. It's lightweight, fast, and the long prongs allow for the lionfish to get trapped after the shot is made. You can find a link to them in the video description. That's a feather duster, not to be confused with a lionfish. Now this alien looking creature is a tigertail sea cucumber. This animal has no eyes and the mouth is at the anterior end. It usually keeps its posterior end firmly anchored in a crack or underneath a rock, then sweeps the surrounding sand and algae covered rocks with the front third of its body. It basically vacuums the detritus, sand, scraps of meaty foods, and algae that it encounters and pushes them into its mouth. It then processes this material in its guts and expels the inedible fragments through its anus. They can reach about 2 meters or 6 feet 7 inches long. Since there seem to be so many small lionfish on this side of the pier, any of these little hidey holes could be occupied by a lionfish. I try to look under and around them all. Even though it's daytime, you'd be surprised how much a dive light helps while lionfish hunting. I'm not sure where this lionfish came from, but if I hadn't turned around, we would have definitely missed it. Now that my prongs are in the proper position for this size lionfish, collecting them became a lot easier. And then there's the one that got away. Looks like JP spotted another one. Thank you. Am I tripping? Are y'all seeing that? I don't see any injuries, so I'm not sure why it's laying there like that. I've never seen a fish play dead. That's a new one. Conch. Nice try, but you're not getting away that easy. There's always something lurking in the shadows. That is not a little eel. I don't know if you can tell from the video, but its head and body is massive. If you look up ahead in the sand, you'll spot several garden eels sticking up out of their burrows. But as we get closer, they retreat into their holes. There is still so much to be seen on the way back to shore. This part of the ocean floor is littered with starfish. Check out their trails. We've got 13 lionfish in the bucket, pretty much all small ones. Thankfully, this set of lionfish never made it to their reproductive state. I'd say it was a pretty successful dive. I'm going to go turn these fish into nuggets, but join me on the next hunt or click the other video to see how to fillet a regular-sized lionfish.